Hi, my name is Michelle Triplett, and in this video, we're going to take a look at how to recruit youth within your church and turn them into future leaders and teachers within your children's ministry. From my experience, one thing that I have seen as a great asset to children's ministry is a dedicated, faithful youth assistant. Youth that have a great heart, that want to serve and want to develop the gifts and talents God has placed in them, can be a huge addition to your volunteer team. So today we're going to take a look at how you can do that within your children's ministry. But before we do that, I want to address one statement a lot of people make whenever I would approach pastors or staff members or even parents or youth leaders within my church. They would say, nope, we need them in service. Yeah, they do need to be in service for the most part. They need to connect with the adults and they need to hear their pastor preach. But what I have found is when we recruit youth to assist within the children's ministry, they retain and grow and gain knowledge of the Bible just through simply being in the classroom and helping the teacher teach the younger kids. And they seem to have fun doing it. And on top of that, we're giving them an opportunity to develop their gifts and talents in the form of being a servant and a volunteer. Those are great points to make when somebody says that to you. So how do you make sure that you recruit youth that have the right heart and motive to work within your children's ministry and join your team? Because we definitely don't want those youth that are simply doing it to get out of service. What we did is we put in place an application process. We handed each youth an application and said, hey, we'd love for you to join our team. We're going to have a lot of fun. We really could use your help. We need you to fill this out and then turn it back into us. In that application, they had to give us some information, turn in a reference to a leader, a pastor, or a teacher at school. They had to get a permission slip signed from their parents saying that they could volunteer. And then they had to sign an acknowledgement form just saying, hey, I'm really committed to this. That eliminated anybody that was simply doing it to get out of service because they were not willing to go through all of those steps just to get out of main service. Now, once we had the application, we would go through the process of interviewing them and then also training them. In the interview process, we would explain to them the vision and purpose of our children's ministry, why they were there, and how much we wanted them to be a part of our team, and what benefit they could get out of it as well as with us. And then we would also explain to them, and this is key, anyone 14 and under didn't get to work with babies or toddlers. Now, some girls get disappointed on this point because they really want to be with those babies. But from my experience, not a safe environment to have anyone 14 or under working with infants and toddlers. What we encouraged them to do was to join preschool or kindergarten. And as they worked and trained in their gift and talent and showed their faithfulness, they could graduate to the nursery because they had proved that they were mature enough to handle a baby and a toddler. And this seemed to work really well. Now let's take a look at the training of on the job as well as shadowing. Now when we came to this, we actually had a very simple 9-page policy and procedure manual that we would actually go over with them because you're not going to get youth to take home a 9-page manual and read it. They're too busy with school and sports and homework. So what we would do is on-the-job training was done on Sundays or Wednesday nights or during a service where somebody would go over that manual with them that just helped them understand how we worked, the process that we went through, where everything was, as well as what our policies and procedures were that we needed them to understand and be a part of. And then we also did some shadowing where they actually got to watch people teach and do the lesson and do the snack, other youth aides that were already trained. This was invaluable to us because it really gave them a chance to connect with us, see what we did, see the purpose and the vision of the children's ministry, and feel a part of something. It gave us a chance to get to know them and maybe see what gifts and talents they had, where they were interested in serving, so that we could place them somewhere they would enjoy being. The other thing we offered them was a youth job description, where we actually went over with them the basic requirements for being a youth aide. Now this was invaluable because they knew what we did and could not, what we expected from them and what they could and could not do. For instance, you can't bring a friend into the room with you and hang out and chat and send texts and laugh and take selfies. If you are working, you're focused. No phones allowed. You can, however, take kids to the bathroom, two at a time. You know, so it was those very important points that we covered with them one-on-one, instead of them having to learn as they go on the job. Because sometimes that can be frustrating and even unsafe. Okay, the last point I want to make is, keep in mind they are youth, especially your junior hires. They love to goof off, have fun, and connect with people. They're going to want to play with the kids in the classroom and sometimes get a little rough with them in the process. Keep your attitude in check. Always make sure that you are ministering to them and working with them from grace and understanding. If you get too strict or you're too short with them, they're going to pick up on that. And then they're not going to trust you as much or want to work within the classroom as much. So there's a good balance between having fun and that time of, hey guys, pull it in, we need to focus and do our job. And if you can keep that balance, things are going to go great. Remember, they are the future leaders and volunteers of your church, and you have the opportunity to mentor them. Thanks for spending time with me today.